Welcome to World Class Championship Wrestling from the State Fair Coliseum in Dallas, Texas. I'm Bill Mercer, and with me, David Von Erich. Well, it seems like controversy just swirls around you guys, starting last week with Kevin and Ric Flair, and now you're into it with Garvin. Let's go back to the Flair thing real quick.
Well, go back to the Flair thing real quick, because it all started out, you know, Flair did toss Kev over the top rope, and if the referee would have seen it, it would have been disqualification right off. The referee did miss it, but he did just so happen to see Kev throwing Flair over the top, so they disqualified Kev, which I think Kev got the raw end of the stick. But the Von Erichs will prevail. They will come out on top. It might not have been last week, but one of these days real soon, it might be Kerry, it might be Kev, and let's don't forget, David's climbing that ladder too, and one of these days I'm going to get a shot at Ric Flair.
And now you've got the challenge of Garvin. And that one was quite spectacular, too. Tonight, though, you got Terry Gordy, and this is to put the handcuff on, huh?
Yeah, that's a little bit of padding I put on my wrist because that handcuff is, you know, is all that metal, and I want to make sure I don't break anything, so it's pretty solid there. But, you know, the main thing I want to say is, Sunshine, you got in my way, darling. I told you not to. I told you if you did, I was going to bend you over and spank you like your daddy needed to do, and that's what I did.
And we'll be back with the Mongo right after this.
World Class Wrestling is sanctioned by the National Wrestling Alliance. David Banning and Fred Sinclair, your official. This bout, a one-fall event with a 20-minute time limit. Devastation Incorporated presents, from points unknown, the Mongol. King Kong Bundy here in the ring with him. His opponent tonight from St. Joseph, Missouri, Mike Bond. Fred Sinclair to officiate.
And here is our bout with the Mongol. A 300-pound plus demon who hails from parts unknown, I suppose, in the origin, some remote area of Mongolia. Noted, of course, in their history for their fighters, their warriors, and they have had a number of prominent wrestlers throughout the world. The Mongol, a part of Devastation Incorporated, and Devastation Incorporated is a bit devastated after Kabuki lost last week to the great Yatsu at the Mongol. See what he can do now, and he hammers away with that rather strange and cultural type of head arrangement he has, his hair. You'll notice it very interesting as he rather quickly comes to work on Mike Bond and hammers him. So the Mongol going to work hard on Mike Bond from St. Joseph, Missouri. Into the corner buckle. That's King Kong Bundy standing by to give an appearance of a sort of a backup or manager. Mike Bond has taken a lot of punishment, continues to take it. He's got a chin lock. World-class championship wrestling throughout the world. Across the United States.
You want some meds? No!
St. Louis, New Orleans. And internationally in Tokyo and Manila.
You want some meds?
Across Mexico. World's last championship wrestling as Bond makes a move. Puts the Mongol on the mat for a second. But the Mongol has come to work hard. And devastatingly, I suppose, as his corporation would indicate. And that's a choke, pure and simple. And don't worry about telling Bond about it. He is in really no position right now. Probably to know exactly what's going on. Looks like he's very, very groggy as the Mongol comes in. Goes in with a reverse chin lock again.
Ask him! He wants some input!
No!
Well, the Mongol knows how to say ask him.
Come on!
Stop the match, Sinclair!
Bundy asking the referee to stop the match because He's afraid the Mongo will annihilate Mike Bond.
Come on!
Well, coming in next week, a couple of very exciting young wrestlers, Chavo Guerrero from Mexico and the British Imperial challenger for the championship, Chris Adams. And Kim Mama. Well, look at Mike Bond come roaring back. Bond didn't know he was out of it. We just thought he did. But the big Mongol picks that knee up and he comes right back into it. So the Mongol was chasing for a moment. And now he does do damage to Bond.
Come on! Bond, you want some dick?
Bond is shaken, groggy, battered. He tried to fight back. But the 300-pounder has just taken all the wind out of him. Tremendous crowd here at State Fair Coliseum in Dallas, Texas for world-class championship wrestling.
You want some dick?
King Kong Bundy relishing this. He and the Mongo look something alike.
Bondy wants a
mitt. No! Ask him!
Bondy wants a mitt!
Bond caught with that nerve over the shoulder. Oh, Bond again says no, he will not submit. We have a report that Kerry Von Erich is doing tremendously well in his journey to Japan in the national tournament there. Just one of two Americans ever invited to that great tournament. We told you last week. The other was his father, Fritz Von Erich, and the report out of Japan is that Kerry is doing very, very well. Oh, that shiver by the Mongol. Ah, look at Bond, he's got to try to battle somewhat.
5 minutes.
Well, Bond continues to get pummeled. Bash really battered. Well, Bond fights back a little. Inside that man is bravery and determination. He's trying to cut through there, but really doesn't have much of a chance of doing much against this 300-pounder. The Mongol, the latest edition of Devastation Incorporated. You're going to meet him a little closer up later in our world-class championship wrestling event. As Bond comes snaking off the ropes. He and the Mongol wrapped up. And the Mongol seems to be able to find within himself the necessary toughness that maybe Bond has but can't quite do. Well, that's tough on the old body. But the Mongo's got him wrapped up in the corner. And Bond is really in a dangerous situation now. That leg out of the top corner buckle. The referee might help Bond right now. The Mongol helps him, pulls him right back down on the mat. Back over the back. Slides him down, kind of a backbreaker, stretcher. Let's see if he's going
to. Bring him up.
And he's going to submit now. The back stretcher. And that just about did it. Bond has taken all he wants and needs from the huge Mongol.
Six minutes
in that one, and the Mongol is the winner. And a fantastic job. Let's go to ringside and our ringside correspondent, Monica Hunter.
King Kong Bundy, now that Kabuki has been defeated, how do you plan on using Mongol in the future?
Let me tell you something. The boss is beside himself with anger. There's no way Yatsu should have beat the great Kabuki, but he did. But look what the boss has gotten now, the Mongol. The boss combed the world to find a talent like the Mongol, and the boss has said, this is it. for Yatsu and Hussein. It's reached the end of the line, and they're finished. It could be the Mongol. It may be Kamala. We're not sure exactly who it's going to be, but they're going to be taken care of.
Next, back with Ric Flair.
Last week of the World Heavyweight Championship match, Ric Flair walked out of here with the championship belt again. During the course of that battle with Kevin Von Erich, Kevin was thrown over the top rope by Flair. Flair was thrown over the top rope twice by Kevin, and Kevin pinned right in the center of the ring Ric Flair. However, the referee came up, found that Kevin had thrown Flair out, and gave the championship back to Flair. An unusual set of circumstances. After the match, we talked to Flair and the referees, and I asked Ric Flair this question.
Career.
You didn't throw him over the top rope.
I did not throw him over the top rope.
Let's watch Kevin Von Erich then and his dive.
His dive? Let's show the primary.
All right, here it comes.
Now I'll tell you what this is right here. This is a conspiracy to humiliate Ric Flair. This is a conspiracy. What is this part right here? This has no right being on film.
This is the part where he comes off and pins you.
He pins me here. Yes, he does. After he threw me over the top rope, ran my head into a post, caused me to bleed, and almost ended my... What is this right here?
That's two.
This is the most humiliating thing that I've ever seen on any national television broadcast anywhere in the world. Nobody believes that. Nobody knows that to be true. He threw me over the top rope. He ran my head in the post. And let me tell you something, Von Erich. You and your old man and your other two brothers have not heard the last of Ric Flair, because I'll be back, and when I am, this time I'm going to have a little something going for me.
Ric Flair, the World Heavyweight Champion. Stepping over here to our right, David Manning and Bronco Lubitsch. Now, gentlemen, this, as I said, this was the most unusual match to Ric Flair. Maybe we better start with Bronco Lubitsch. You kind of got it in the back and on the head early in this one. But at that point, right after that, Ric Flair says he didn't, but it appeared to us that he threw Kevin Von Erich over the top rope.
Well, here's what happened. When I collided with Kevin, I fell outside on the floor, and I was laying facing up. Manning came to assist me. He picked me up, and I've seen Flair flying over the top rope as Kevin threw him over.
Now, that was later now. That was the...
I didn't see the other part.
You didn't see the other. You were on the other side of the ring.
I was practically knocked out. Anyways... Whatever happened afterwards, it's irrelevant. Now, technically, Kevin Von Erich should be the champion. But rules are rules, and I can't help that. I've seen Flair flying over the top rope. That was the end of the match. Anything that happened afterwards was irrelevant.
All right, what was your view of this, David?
Well, my view is very plain and simple. I went down the ring. I stepped in for Bronco Lubitsch, and you know, which is a bad thing.
I must say, you're not the official referee in that circumstance, even.
In that circumstance, once I took over, I was the
official
referee.
Right.
And you know, rules are rules; they can't be changed, they can't be bent. But no matter what's said, in my opinion,
I'll tell you what the rules are. Just a minute. You're talking to the World Heavyweight Champion. You're not an official during my match tonight. You belong back here. Bronco Lubitsch was the official. True or false? And nobody comes into a match unauthorized, and nobody authorized you to be down there. Nobody authorized you to count my shoulders in a mat. And I'll tell you right now, I know what's going on in the state of Texas. It's a conspiracy against Ric Flair. I'm the greatest champion alive, and Bronco Lubitsch, I want to shake your hand because you did an excellent job of refereeing that match tonight.
No matter what the rules say, no matter how much you can bend them, in my opinion, right now, Kevin Von Erich is the World Heavyweight Champion.
No, he made a statement. He said, you were in the back. There's a monitor in the back. Did you see Flair throw Kevin over the top rope in the back?
No, I didn't.
You did not see
it. The people came in. One of the ushers asked me to come to the ring. Bronco was hurt. That's what I did.
Okay, that's you missed.
My opinion, Kevin Von Erich is the World Heavyweight
Champion. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you, Bronco. Thank you, David Manning and Ric Flair, the World Champion. Still the World Champion. And now making his way to the ring, King Kong Bundy, Mr. Devastation Incorporated himself, as Bundy comes to the ring and gets ready for this bout on World Class Championship Wrestling. Let's go to Mark Lawrence in the ring.
I said I was
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a one-fall bout with a 10-minute time limit. First from San Antonio, Texas, superstar Jose Lothario. And his opponent from Nome, Alaska, 450 pounds, King Kong Bundy. Fred Sinclair, your referee.
And we're ready to go with King Kong Bundy and that popular young man south of the border, Jose Lothario. Jose comes out of San Antonio. Very popular in Mexico. Very popular everywhere. Jose Lothario, veteran. Outstanding, knows how to box, knows how to move in. You see Bundy backing out of there. Bundy, of course, has taken about 180 pounds. Add that to his bulk, and the King Kong man ready to go against Jose Lothario. And coming up tonight, you're going to meet very close and up close and up tight, Kimbala. And of course, our great bout between David Von Erich and Terry Gordy. And they're handcuffed together. Jose Lothario right now moves in on Bundy. Lothario's not one that would back off. And Bundy. Bundy and Devastation Incorporated suffering a great shock. And the great Kabuki was beaten by Yatsu. They consider the fact that once they had Kamala, the Mongol, and Kabuki, they were just undefeatable. They were going to be supreme in the ranks. Well, that's just like anything else. Somebody's going to win, somebody's going to lose, and you never know. Jose Lothario. Got a wrist lock in there. Going to try to pull it back now with Bundy exerting his strength and influence. Well, this huge crowd on hand to witness this, another world-class championship match in our main event. It's me, David Von Erich and Terry Gordy. Jose Lothario starting to put a kick in the midsection, changed his mind. Lothario and Bundy, one fall match, 20 minute time limit. Now Bundy comes in, twisting wrist lock. Jose, got the crowd behind him, snapping on that wrist, King Kong Bundy. And Bundy wants to try to salvage something out. Of course, the Mongol easily won the first bout. And as we said last week, Yatsu beat Kabuki. Mentioning some of the newcomers who you'll be seeing shortly, Chavo Guerrera. Very famous wrestling name in Mexico. And one of the future bright British stars who very well be the British Empire champion. A very pleasant Englishman named Chris Adams. Big headlock right now, hard headlock by King Kong Bundy on Jose Lothario. Oh, Bundy doing a job on him right now. Rolling that headlock. Bundy holds it on. Well, Lothario's trying to take the leg out of Bundy to get him down. He didn't knock him down, but he did break the hold. And he put a dent in the hamstring of King Kong Bundy.
Back him up, Sinclair.
I'm going to kill you, Mexican.
Well, Bundy certainly gets his point across, doesn't he? And world-class championship wrestling is certainly around the world. Tokyo, Manila, Mexico, Kuwait, and in our United States, from the east to the west, St. Louis, New Orleans, all around the country. Jose Lothario, been taking a little punishment of late. Takes a little bit sometimes, he gets wound up. Oh, Jose right now going after Bundy. And King Kong is a formidable foe. Like smashing away. Smashing away on Lothario. Now Lothario goes that boxing stance. It's set, ready to go. Jose wanted to pop him with that fist. Thought better of it. Well, the awesome Kamala will be here next week. And he is an awesome one. That's Bundy and Lothario.
Bundy break it.
Five minutes gone in this bout. Lothario whips him across the head. Jose going after. Certainly he's got the deficit in size. Nice move inside by Lothario. And a toho right now. Maybe got a drop on that left leg of King Kong Bundy. Well, a jamming in the knee, putting a vice in there and a little lever.
Huskin, you want to submit?
No!
Bundy's not going to submit, but he's not in a real comfortable position right now.
You want to submit?
Yeah, we got it all spread out here, and a toehold beginning to spin with Lothario really in command at the moment. It's tough for Bundy to try to figure out to do anything here. Perspiration jumping out on his forehead as Lothario spins a toe. Word from Japan is that Kerry Von Erich's doing magnificently. They're doing a great job. Invited to the national tournament there. As count of two, almost got Bundy on that one. Lothario stays with it. Well, Lothario got a kick in the head on that one. And that forced him to break. Well, here comes Bundy. 3 minutes remaining in this bout. King Kong Bundy, hopping away. Lothario, oh, he got that elbow in the neck, and Bundy thinks it's all over. It might be with that 450 pounds dropping in. One, no, Lothario flails right out of there. Reverse chin lock. King Kong Bundy, Devastation Incorporated.
You want some mat?
Trying to pick up a victory here.
Us!
You want some mat?
Us!
Bundy really holding in that chin lock.
You want some mat?
You want some mat?
Right across the midsection.
Us!
King Kong Hammering away. Big Bundy on Jose Lothario. They don't have much time left. Oh, what a shot by Lothario. Well, these two really hammer it out right now. Oh, these two big men really wrapping it up here at the end. Lothario. 1 minute to go as Lothario takes a bump into his chest. Well, Lothario certainly having trouble right getting back in this match. Oh, but King Kong missed it. And now King Kong's in trouble with about 30 seconds left. Just about 30 seconds left, and Lothario is fighting back. What a left hook. A right shot, right on the jaw. There's a blast on the nose, just 15 seconds left. Left hook to the jaw. Another. Oh, look at Lothario really unload. Lothario left and right to the head and face. And they go at the bell and still fighting. Well, a great finish by Jose Lothario. And it's going to be, I imagine, a draw. The referee can determine if there's a winner.
A 10-minute time limit, therefore the bout will be a time limit draw.
A time limit draw between Jose Lothario and King Kong Bundy. So that's it. King Kong Bundy and Jose Lothario battling to a draw. Now they want to go a little bit more. I don't know if Bundy wants to put up with that boxing style of Jose Lothario or not. Well, that's all for Bundy. He said, no, no way about that. And Bundy leaves. Heads for the rear. That's enough as Jose Lothario and Bundy wind it up. Next coming up, the tape with Kamala. Right out in the jungle. We'll be right back with that after this. It takes a little doing to find some of the wrestlers of the world like Kamala, but we persevered, and here's what we found.
We're here on the beautiful estate of Mr. Akbar, the man. You've met him before, and I thank you, sir, for having us out here. I wonder why we're meeting in this forest rather than up on the hill at your beautiful mansion.
Well, first of all, Mercer Kamala must be kept in his natural surroundings. Otherwise, he will suffer from culture shock. This is the reason you're meeting me here, Mercer.
So this is his normal environment, then?
Exactly.
Who are these men with you? I know Mr. Kumar to your left. Would you introduce the others?
Meet the Mongol, 300 pounds plus internationally known wrestler. And by the way, the problems in this area have become more so. This explains the presence of the Mongol in the general stable at this time.
And the man over here with the helmet on?
Meet Friday, the caretaker of Kamala. He is with Kamala constantly. He is with him at all times. He is more or less, as I've said before, his caretaker.
All right, now speaking of Kamala, could you bring him in so we could meet him?
Well, of course, but I must have assurance from the cameraman that there will be no sudden flash bulbs, no disturbances of any kind, because this man could become uncontrollable, dynamite, as you Americans say at times.
Well, I'm sure that our cameraman, the reporters, will not bother us here. Tell me about the situation now with your bringing in Kamala.
Well, of course, it's a twofold situation. First of all, as you know, Kabuki has been injured by Hussein and that dog Yatsu. And of course, Kamala will take care of that situation. The other is the Von Erich family, the snotty-nosed young punks called the Von Erichs, who have been in this area much too long. And in due time, we shall get to that situation, I assure you. Now, this man, the Mongol, as I've said before, he is devastation himself. and a welcome member to Devastation Incorporated. And now Kamala is on his way, 6'9", 385 pounds. And as I've said before, he is uncontrollable at moments, Mercer.
Well, he is an awesome sight. I would like to hear him speak in his native tongue, though.
Could you say something for him? Hey, watch it. Look out. Hey.
And the former Texas heavyweight champion makes a dramatic appearance. And now let's go to Mark Lawrence in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout, one fall to a man is defeated. First of all, let me say this will be a handcuff bout. The two men will be handcuffed together. First, from Denton County, Texas, David Von Erich. And his opponent, with Michael Hayes at his side, Freebird Terry Gordy. David Manning, the referee, he has the handcuffs.
So David Manning will apply the handcuffs. And that's an interesting battle to have.
All right, once they're handcuffed together, this
here's David Manning.
One up and the other.
All right, no problem, that'll be Terry.
Michael Hayes and David Manning discussing the possibilities. And David Von Erich is ready to go to battle with Gordy. David Von Erich, last week.
As soon as the bell rings, Michael Hayes is to be in the back.
Michael Hayes has to leave the ring and the arena. So that's a surprise to Michael Hayes. David Manning sending Michael Hayes to the back. There are no other Von Erichs in the ring. So Michael Hayes must be evicted from the premises. David Von Erich, as I was going to say last week, issued a challenge to gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And that erupted into a post-battle fracas with David Von Erich spanking Sunshine, who is gorgeous Jimmy Garvin's valet.
If you don't please stop throwing garbage, we're going to stop the battle. Please don't throw anything else.
Well, I don't know where Gordy's headed, but he's headed somewhere. Now, David Von Erich is waiting for the bout to commence, but Michael Hayes has to leave the arena.
You all please don't throw anything, because I don't want that coward to have no reason not to get in this ring with me. We're gonna kick Freebird's butt.
And this huge crowd enjoying David Von Erich as he taunts his adversaries. Michael Hayes in the sunglasses. And Terry Gordy. Well, we'd like to get this one rolling. As soon as Gordy decides he's going to get in the bout. David Von Erich will be handcuffed in. Well, there it is, all locked up and ready to go. Now here comes the 300-pound Terry Gordy. But he knows that David Von Erich is of particular.
It's gonna be war!
Oh, fella hit the deck. And Gordy. A little heated up as he has to go in and work against David Von Erich. So Gordy is hesitant to get in the ring. And David Von Erich is ready for it. Kerry Gordy just taking his own sweet time and getting to this bout. And maybe he is justified in that and having to be handcuffed up to David Von Erich. But Gordy looks like he's about ready now. Yeah, Gordy doesn't really seem to want to be in this bout at all. Kerry Gordy must feel lost without his brother. The other two parts of the Freebirds, Michael Hayes and Buddy Roberts. And David Von Erich is handcuffed. Kerry Gordy is very hesitant about this. Now we'll try it again. It's like trying to hitch up a couple of mules to a wagon. These guys are both pretty stubborn and tough. Got them all set up and ready to go. And it's, boy, I tell you one thing, you got a lot of room to maneuver, have you? Certainly Gordy now is in all sorts of trouble immediately as David Von Erich works him over. But he can't leave the ring. When you throw a man, you got to go with him. And David Von Erich is moving right along with Gordy. And this is the handcuff match. David Von Erich slapping and firing away. Well, Gordy already down one, two, but not three. And Gordy is still there. Now, Gordy's handcuff has slipped off his protective covering. Well, he may get a little bite in his wrist there. As David Von Erich works the wrist lock. The thing the handcuffs do is keep the two adversaries right on top of each other. And in the case of David Von Erich, who's giving up some weight, that might be just as well working with a big man like Gordy. But here comes Gordy now. And he's trying to use handcuffs, fists, and everything to get into this bout again. Gordy unleashing an attack now on David Von Erich. David Von Erich wants that Texas Heavyweight Championship back. And right now, Terry Gordy is not concerned about that. He's concerned about saving some face for the Freebirds. They've had their problems of late.
I'm gonna kill it!
You can't choke him in
a corner. I'm gonna kill it!
Get him out! One, two, three!
Well, probably he's not going to go that far, but he might very well like to put David. Whoa, there's a tough situation, biting him right across the nose. David Von Erich will shake it up right now. Kerry Gordy, who didn't want to enter this handcuff bout, but got into it now and is doing pretty well. Now, here's an interesting situation. Handcuffed. And pulling here and pulling him back. And David has a cut on his forehead. Get that rule. Handcuff chain across the mouth. That's gonna be tough. But the handcuff is part of the battle, so that's the legal situation here. This bout has a cut right in the middle of David's head. Must have caught that chain on his head, a part of the head cut. Gordy in charge at the moment. It says 300 pounds on the back of David Von Erich. As David Manning, the referee, watches very carefully. Great move by David Von Erich, an uppercut to the side of the head. And David hammers around with that protective covering and the handcuff. Does another job on him. David Von Erich. Taking it back, and he has the claw hold on Gordy in the corner. That's broken by Gordy's move. I got Evan. Trying to get him up for a pile driver. David won't budge. Gordy trying to exert his strength in his effort to take David Von Erich, but Von Erich is fighting back inside. On top. One, two, three. David Von Erich wins the handcuff match. What a move by David Von Erich. He was shaken. That underneath turned him upside down and got Gordy. And got the count of three for the victory.
6 minutes, 20 seconds. David Von Erich, your winner.
6 minutes and 20 seconds. David Von Erich, the winner. Here comes Michael Hayes in again. Oh, we're going to have beat on David Von Erich time. And Michael Hayes and Gordy now getting their pound of flesh right here. David wrapped up the top rope. But here comes some assistance from the back, the Iceman coming in. The Iceman coming up. And all sorts of mayhem going on. And it is a fracas. This enormous crowd going to the defense of David Von Erich. Now David's out of the rope, and there's Michael Hayes, the shot. The Iceman. Here's Michael Hayes, and David has a handful. Oh, it isn't over yet. What a wild experience that was. And that is David Von Erich's victory over Terry Gordy. We'll be back with the Freebirds in our next segment. Well, the fabulous Freebirds, Terry Gordy, Michael Hayes. This was a tough night, Mr. Terry Gordy. That handcuff match was a brutal one.
Well, that's right, it was, you know, but I like stuff like that. You know, I like to get in there, and I like to mix it up because I like to be nasty, because I'm a nasty individual, you know, just as it is, and I don't mind getting in there and rubbing somebody's face into the mat, and I don't mind getting in there and hurting somebody. And I don't mind popping an arm, man. And you know something that makes me mad, man?
What's that?
I hear all these people in Texas out here talking about, go home, Freebirds, go home, Freebirds. Well, let me tell you something, Texas, there ain't no other place that I would rather be than in Georgia right now. But I got business to take care of, and I got money to make, and I got some people that I want to whoop.
Well, let me get Michael to give you a final report.
We got just a second. Give me the microphone. Hey, I'm talking about the Von Erichs. I'm going to give an awful whooping to you, boy, an awful whooping.
And that's World Class Championship Wrestling. Thank you, man.